Well, children, last class we discussed about various phylums. Phylum Coryphera, phylum Coelenterata, phylum Tenopora, phylum Platyhelminthes, phylum Haskelminthes. All these things we discussed last class. I think you know what are the special characteristics of Coryphera, what are the special characteristics of Coelenterata, and examples for the Coelenterata, how many species on the earth under the phylum Coryphera and also Coelenterata, Tenophora, I think a very less specimen under that phylum Tenophora, Platyhelminthes, Latworms, Haskelminthes. All these things, the habitat, characteristics of the body, diploblastic or diploblastic, or what type of animal to live in a particular place, like habitat and habit, and nature of levels of organization, like cell level, tissue level, organ level, everything will clarify after the Haskelminthes. So, last class is now Coryphera, Coelenterata, Tenophora, Platyhelminthes, Haskelminthes, all classes. This is all the phylums explained. That is, there is a species that is there, any vessel that is there, habitat, that is nature, cellular level, tissue level, organ level, organ system level, that is reproduction, external characters, internal characters, all of them will be told. Today we are going to one more phylum, go to the Annelida. Phylum Annelida. In this phylum Annelida, it is one of the non-featured animals phylum. It includes 15,000 organisms under the phylum Annelida. It is a segmented body, Annelida, segmented body. I think you know, once I give you the example, you can able to understand that Annelida character is, that is Neris. Neris, centipede, millipede, all these things comes under the phylum Annelida. I think these special animals, like a herbivore, or in case of Neris, as any animal under this phylum Annelida, it is a segmented body. Body will be segmented throughout anterior to posterior view. The first character, almost all these animals lived in the water, aquatic life, as well as terrestrial life, soil, moist soil, and also sometimes it will be in wet soil also. So these are the animals having the characters have that will be lived in different areas, aquatic as well as terrestrial. So these two, aquatic and terrestrial, at different climatic conditions, the Annelida, while the Annelida or the Annelida animals will be lived. They are one by one, we will know the things. First one is, that is grade of organization, organ level system. Grade of organization, organ level. This will be, remember, organ level, already I have explained the meaning of organ level. The meaning of organ level, it will be cellular stage, then tissue, then organ system. This is not organ system. Organ level will be there. So it is not a well developed organ system. In these animals, it will be having a particular organs. So it is an organ level system. Second one is a body shape. Almost the segmented body. Segmented for all the animals having a segmented. The diagrams, everything it is there in your textbook, you can copy down. The body will be segmented like this. The body segmented like this. Any animal, whether it go to the kneeling or whatever may be, it will be segmented. In this segment, it is a small, unwell developed ear-like structure. It will be legs moving from place to place. And also, in case of this earthworm also, it is having a different body segment. Therefore, this is the special character of a annelida. This is commonly called as a segmented. Next, we go to the symmetry. It is a bilateral symmetry. The bilateral symmetry. This bilaterally, the animal will be divided into two. It's a bilateral symmetry. Body wall triploblastic. Triploblastic. What is the meaning of triploblastic? Already I have explained the three layers of the body. That is, we commonly call it as a triploblastic: ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. Triploblastic animals. So here, one more. The body cavity, coelomic epithelium, and the locomotor organs will be present in the body. Digestive system, it will be tract. One of the tract, it will be not like a human being tract, but developed digestive system take place. What are the materials to be taken? Will be digested and coming out from the anus like a digestive system. The respiratory system will be moist skin. With the help of this skin, moist skin, oxygen, dissolved oxygen will be respired with a specialized cells. That is the moist skin. Moist means devamsha, moist skin. With the help of the moist skin, the respiration take place. Respiration is going on. Nervous system, cerebral ganglia, brain, and also double ventral nerve cord will be present. It will be responsible for the processes in the body. So nervous system also develops. It is not a well developed, it will be developed. Nervous system present in the annelida or in case of annelida phylum, nereis. For example, nereis only it will be showing. Excretory system, how our animals, our human beings, nephrons and kidney is responsible for respiratory system. Here also in annelida having a excretory system, that nephriodophore, that nephridia is the organ. It will be supporting for the unwanted materials, chemical substances going out or the set out or the throw out from the body. It will be just like our excretory system of our human body. Reproduction, commonly separate sexes are separate. Sexes are separate. That is the hermaphrodite. It will be the same, the character. It will be male and female. And development takes place. It is inside the larval development. Commonly we call it as, it is a sexual reproduction. It is larval will be develops. Sometimes reproduce asexually by budding or the fusion. Some of the animals in the phylum annelida. So in this annelida, commonly we will show two types of reproduction. One is sexual reproduction and one more is asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, it is a budding take place, some of the few animals. Sexual reproduction, that is a combination of male and female, like a sperm and egg. It is the male sex organs. This will be responsible for the sexual reproduction and will be regeneration of our larva or the small offsprings. Next we will go to the phylum Annelida, divided into four classes. This is the most important in your examination point of view. Phylum Annelida divided into four class. Number one, Polyketa, Polyketa, P-O-L-Y, Polyketa, Polyketa. Number two, C-H-A-E, Polyketa, C-H-A-E, C-H-A-E, Polyketa. Many right ears, that is a walking. It means the example for me is and Aphrodite. Next one, going to the Oligoketa, Oligoketa, Oligo, C-H-A-E, Oligoketa. What is the meaning of Oligoketa? It is a, includes the mostly fish water, terrestrial forms with a few, it is like a health form. Like Oligo, it is the Oligo means here few. Few will be, it will be helpful for the leaf in the earth as well as the water. Oligoketa. First one is Polyketa, poly number of like this. Air like structure helpful for the walking or the moving place to place. So Polyketa, Oligoketa very less. And Irudinia, Irudina. H-I-R-U-D-A-N-E-A. Irudina, that is commonly called as a blood sucking cartilage. It is a leeches. Why Irudina? It is includes the leech comes under the is the ectoparasites. So the Annelida character is having is an ectoparasites also present in Annelida phylum. Then finally, Archaeopteryx. Archina, Archinida, Archini, A-R-C-H-I-L-N-C-H-I-A, R-C-H-I-A, will be silent, Archinida, Archini, Archinida. What is the meaning of Archinida here? Poly Gorodus, it is includes exclusively marine forms. It divided into shed under parapodia. Parapodia and shed will be divided. It is commonly Archinidia, Archinilidia, Archinilida. Okay, all this comes under the phylum Annelida. Next we are going to Arthropoda. I think it is in Canada, very simple. While a Annelida another, Niriso, Pasvanatna, Norka, Chipsipuru, Arthuano, Ella Uta Kitakata, animals, Annelida characters. So you have segmented body, body will divide segment tiger there, organ level in the bilateral symmetry tiger there, Baga Marbodo, equal divide Marbodo, triploblastic, more Bago, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm, Mandirate, Amale, Idu Kamanagi. Skin, all kinds of animals. That is why the Sahara species is here. That is why the Sahara species is here. But sexual reproduction is asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is what is that? Egg and sperm. It is a two sexes are separate. And asexual reproduction is budding hybrid. That is why we are here. Next we will go to the phylum Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda. Arthropoda. Here Arthro means joint. Poda means foots. Joint foots are commonly called as आर्थ्रोपोडा। आर्थ्रोपोडा ये कॉमनली आर्थ्रोपोडा नियरली 10 लाख टोटली 10 लाख स्पेसिमेंस इन दिस फाइलम आर्थ्रोपोडा 10 लाख स्पेसिमेंस। I think it is one of the biggest phylum in animal kingdom. 10 lakh species in this arthropoda. Okay.
Triploblastic means, what is the meaning of triploblastic? It is
Triploblastic is tri-layered wall. There is a inner wall, inner, outer, and middle mesoderm. Those commonly called as a triploblastic. They will go to the body cavity. True serum will be present in the body. It present between the body wall and the elementary canal. The body cavity arises by the splitting of mesoderm liquid between the coelomic epithelium. The epithelial cells will be used for the blood circulation as well as the body system. So these are the common features of the animals under the arthropoda. Body division will be head thorax and abdomen region. Head region, thorax region, abdomen region. The three parts, head and thorax, abdomen. The three levels of the body, head region, abdomen region, and the thorax region. The head, thorax, and abdomen is the common three parts, and also it will be thorax, it is for the cephalothorax region. Here, the arthropoda animals will be divided into three, head, thorax, abdomen. They say, why we not call it as a tail? Because the abdomen part itself indicating that is a excretory reproductory out organs will be present on the body. Hence, arthropoda character, that is example of these animals, commonly three parts of the body. So, digestive system, mouth will be there, and also some undeveloped digestive system present in this phylum arthropoda. Then, nervous system, circulatory system, open type of circulatory system, not like our human beings and our vertebrates like heart. And what is the composition? That is the four chambers of the heart, like not a well developed organ system for the blood circulatory system, open blood circulatory system. There is no proper organ for the blood circulating. It will be open wall system, commonly undeveloped blood circulatory system that will be supporting for the blood towards the parts of the body. It is a commonly it is almost the colorless blood also present. Nervous system, cerebral ganglia, brain, and also subparietal ganglia will be present. That's segmental ganglia in each segment, each and every segment having a ganglia that will be supporting for the what? Supporting for the transport of information of the animal while sensing, while touching, while whatever the things will react with the help of the nervous system. So, excretory system like a malpighian tubules which are open into the intestine, each and every intestine part having a malpighian tubules, they are supporting for the excretory system. Unwanted substance will be given out of the body. Then reproduction, sexes are separate, fertilization is external, and few aquatic forms in the internal, majority development of direct or indirect in larval stage, direct as well as indirect. The internal fertilization, sometimes it will be external fertilization. External fertilization is nothing but outside the body, egg formation of larva. So, external fertilization takes place. It is the type of reproduction and arthropoda. Now, this arthropoda divided into six classes. One is onychophora, that is onychophora. It is a peripatus. It is annelidan arthropods. That comes under the crustacean, coelopoda, diplopoda, insecta, archaeida. These are the six classes under the phylum arthropoda. First is onychophora. Onychophora body is vermiform with distinct head, pair of eye, tentacles, trunk base pair unjointed stumpy legs ending in a close excreting by nephrodia. That is commonly the class under the phylum arthropoda. That is a onychophora. Crustacea, body will be differentiating into cephalothorax, abdomen. It will be externally externally reproduction will take place and the chitin will be exoskeleton supporting for the these animals. Means called as a crustacea. Coelopoda. Coelopoda means commonly the vermiform differentiated to the head trunk. Trunk means with a pair of jagged legs. The trunk region, the middle of the animal. That is the trunk region. Commonly what we call it as this head region. This is the tail region, the trunk region having a the leg, these legs are supporting for the walking. See that is, that's why the class we commonly call it as a Coelopoda, Coelopoda, okay. This is a trunk based on a pair of jointed legs. First pair leg based poison operators. Because those poison operators protect from the animal, from external animals are the foreign substances and also other animals. Next we will go to the insecta. Body differentiating into head, thorax and also abdomen. Thorax based on the three pairs of the legs. Insecta, already you know, insect will be a three-part. So here will be having a legs, the two pairs of legs. This commonly we call it as insecta. So insecta comes under this family arthropoda. That is body differentiating into three thorax, abdomen, thorax, the three pairs of the legs. The legs will be thorax region. Then archaeida, body differentiated into the cephalothorax and abdomen. Cephalothorax based the pairs of legs. Abdomen divided into appendages. Spiders, scorpions, ticks. Scorpion already known. Archaeida scorpion having its special characters. How the animal will be shaped. See like this, the different characters under this phylum arthropoda. I think in Kannada arthropoda tumba simple. Arthropoda nalli bartakkanta 10 lakh species barutte. 10 lakh species 80% animal biology nalli zoology nalli bartakkanta kingdom animal animalian nalli 80% cover agutte arthropoda. 10 lakh species nalli irutte. Illi enella characters irutte organization ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ವರ್ಗೂ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಲೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಕ್ಟೋಡರ್ಮ್, ಎಂಡೋಡರ್ಮ್, ಮೀಸೋಡರ್ಮ್ ಮೂರು ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಎಂಡೋಡರ್ಮ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಎರಡು ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸೆಕ್ಸಿಸಲ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಇದು ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಕೆಲವು ಮೊಟ್ಟೆ ಇಡುತ್ತೆ, ಓವಿಪೇರ್ಸ್, ಕೆಲವು ಓವಿಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಿದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಎ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗೋ ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲಿಯನ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ನ್ಯೂರಾನ್ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಡೋ ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವೇನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಈ ಮೂರು ಅಂಶಗಳನ್ನ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ಮು, ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ಮು, ಮಿಡಲ್ ಒಬ್ಲಾಂಗೇಟ, ಈ ಮೂರು ಅಂಶಗಳು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಟರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗೇನೇ ಇತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಹಲೋ ಸರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆಯಾ ಇನ್ನೂ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರಾ ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷ.